In this video, we'll take a quick look at the ABC sensors on your Garmin Instinct, otherwise known as the Altimeter, Barometer, and Compass. In order to access these sensors on demand, all we have to do is press and hold the ABC button and we'll get to our screens. Here's our Altimeter screen, Barometer screen, Compass screen, and we got our 3-in-1, which is very useful depending on what you're doing here. So let's go back to Altimeter. And by pressing the GPS button, we can go and configure some of these settings. First is the calibrate. Now this shares the same feature as in the barometer screen where we need the elevation data. Now we can use a GPS feature to determine or estimate the elevation, or if we really know what our current elevation is, given where we are, topo maps, GIS data, we can go in and manually enter it. So I'm just gonna go and choose yes and manually enter it. Now, I configured it a couple of minutes ago, so it just happens to be at the right elevation, but if you needed to reset it, for example, you can go through and just set it at the right. So depending where you are, it might be off by a little bit, might be off by a lot, but at least you have the option to set it based on your situation. Here we can turn on or off the auto calibration. You may want to do that. And of course, the units for your elevation, meters or in feet. Now let's get down to the barometer settings. So you can see here we have the high low features. The high here, you can see that by this graph, we have the 6-hour graph, our current value. So let's go in, press GPS. Again, we can calibrate. Again, it will ask us for elevation. Well, let's go in and say yes. Again, it's the same value, so it doesn't really matter. Or we can use the GPS. And we can use the plot. So we had our 6-hour graph in the previous screen. We can go and change that to 12 hours or 24 hours or even 48 hours. 12 hours is a good measure. And we have a nice feature here called the storm alert. Now, in the previous video I've done, I've kind of explained how you can use your Garmin barometer using the Phoenix series barometer to try to predict weather. Storm alert is a nice little feature that you can have to help you with that. And when you go in, you can turn on and off the storm alert feature, and you can have the rate when the alarm will trigger. So in the other video, I've shown that anything above 1 to 3 hectopascals per 3 hours. That's a low front, so it's a slow, low pressure coming in. Once you're between 4 and 6, there's something coming relatively quickly. And of course, if you get something a little bit higher, then you get a pretty good storm coming along. So a good setting probably, if you want, is probably 4.5. That gives you a good indication that you have some nasty weather coming relatively soon, in a few hours or something like that. So you can go back and watch mode here. This is when the sensor turns on. We have it on auto. And of course the pressure units, hectopascals or millibars or some of the other features, hectopascals. And rule of thumb, closer you are to sea level, once you're below 1,000, means that you're in pretty nasty weather. If you are a hurricane watcher or tracker, this pressure is well below 1,000 normally. So this is a pretty good indicator to help you predict weather within a few hours, whether or not you're expecting a little bit of rain, a little bit of rain and wind, or some major storm conditions coming. Finally, we have our compass. From here, we can press the GPS. This is where we can calibrate our compass screen. We covered that in another video, how you can do the figure eight, try to rotate it to get it to calibrate, change our display from degrees, mils, and all that. Change our northern reference from true north, magnetic north, grid, or user. And again, the mode that we can turn on the sensor, automatic, or basically on demand, or turn it off. And that is basically it, how you can adjust your ABC sensors on your Garmin Instinct.